writing provider independent code. See, all the code we have been writing till now was very specific to SQL Server and using the namespace system.data.sqlclient and the corresponding classes like SQL connection, SQL command, SQL data reader, SQL parameter. All these classes are very specific to SQL Server managed provider. What if I decide to tomorrow use Oracle database? With what we have today, everything will have to be changed from SQL client to Oracle client. And similarly, if I use Access from Oracle client to further OLEDB client. So all this code, which is specific to SQL Server right now, we have to somehow see that becomes provider independent. Now, how can we make it provider independent? When I was giving you introduction to managed provider, at that point, I clearly said every managed provider is implementing a common set of interfaces for a specific database. So if only I can replace everywhere classes with interfaces, will our problem get solved? Only if we can program with interface, our code will become generic. The issue is how the objects will be created. Interfaces cannot be instantiated. So how the object will be created is the basic question we have to ask now. So what I'll do is, first let me copy at least two methods which I would show you we can convert from provider specific to provider independent code. In one case, I would like to execute, let us say, a stored procedure which has some parameters. And in another case, I would like to execute a query which is for fetching. One we can say is insert operation, and the other is let us say is select operation. Two operations I would like to do now in provider independent way. So insert btn insert. Now going to form, if we remember, we have written insert along with photo using stored procedure. This whole thing I am copying now, where everything is specific to SQL Server. Parameter, command, connection, all this is specific to SQL Server. And I'll paste this in this insert click. And this code, I would like to change it to obviously system dot. I mean, I would like to make it completely provider independent. Right now, it is going to use system.data.sqlclient. I don't even want to mention this system.data.sqlclient on top. So at the first level, I'll prefer converting all this into interfaces. So for connection, we have got interface called as IDB connection. So right here, IDB connection. And this is in system.data namespace, which is common for all anyhow. Yes, we cannot write new IDB connection, and that is what is the limitation. So we'll see what can be done there. But yes, connection string can be set through connection.connection string is equal to helper.connection string. Good enough. Insert, that can remain. And here I'll change it to IDB command. Now how do we create a command object? Right now we are doing new SQL command. This has to be replaced with connection dot, in connection we have got create command, and this create command will create the command object with the connection object which was specifically instantiated here, and that we haven't done. See, here we can get probably OLEDB command connection, we might get ODBC connection, we might get Oracle connection, we might get any connection. Right now it is SQL connection. So this is going to create SQL command object. If this is Oracle connection, this will create Oracle command object. So appropriate command object will be taken care by the corresponding connection. That's not a worry. And now we have to set the two properties, which we will set here. Command dot command text, the first connection, and then command dot command text, which is the name of stored procedure. That is SQL in our case. Now all this parameter, I copy vertical, I data parameter is the interface. Now how to create parameter objects? To create parameter object, in command we have got create parameter. This is what we'll have to do. And then we'll have to set parameter name. There is a readymade property which we can use for setting the parameter name. Parameter emp name dot parameter name, which is supposed to be name. And then we'll have to set parameter type, DB type. This we should not use SQL DB type, because SQL DB type is again SQL Server specific. So what is that we would use? See, this is again system dot data dot SQL client dot SQL parameter, and all this we'll be using. So we have another type called as DB type dot string, or where char is not there. So DB type dot string can be used, and then of course parameter emp name dot size. Parameter emp name dot size is not there. DB type we have set as string, and that takes care of, so no problem. Okay, next, same thing we'll have to do even for the other parameters. So I'll just copy paste for ID, and something similar we'll have photo. Let us skip, we don't want photo, otherwise I'll have to prepare for all that image and everything. So this is emp name, change to emp salary, emp salary, emp salary, emp id, emp id, emp id, emp id. So this first line can be deleted now. Here parameter name is id, salary, we don't want photo, we'll send null, and rather we'll keep the parameter photo, but we'll send the value as null. So we will learn how to send null value using parameters also. So here also we should do create parameter, command dot create parameter, and then we'll give parameter photo dot parameter name is equal to, and then parameter photo dot DB type is equal to DB type dot, we want something which can accommodate binary. And EMP ID direction should be output, parameters should be added, all fine. The data now, we want to take it from text box, but right now let me hard code it. It's name is something like, let's say E1, salary, buffer we don't have, so we want to give the value for parameter as null only. We open the connection, we execute, whatever rat value we get, we'll display that in the message box. So nowhere now you see, except in the connection place, we have code for provider specific thing. Only this problem I have to solve now. Otherwise, we have converted the whole code to be completely provider independent. Though we had to write little extra lines of code, but the code is completely provider independent. Now, how do we solve this problem? To solve this problem, we have been given with a namespace system.data.common. And in system.data.common namespace, Microsoft has provided us with some factories. So we have some class called as DB provider factories. Represents a set of static methods for creating one or more instances of factory classes. So we are going to use factories class, which has method called as getFactory. And this getFactory we have to give either data row which is provider row, or else we can give the DB connection, or else we can give a provider invariant name. I'll prefer giving provider invariant name, and that provider invariant name is supposed to be something like, if it is SQL Server, system.data.sqlclient. Likewise, for every managed provider, there is going to be some name. That name we will have to give here. What is important is, this is a string and returns provider factory. So close this, and what we will now get, DB provider factory is equal to See, basically advantage is what? Now programmatically we can decide the factory is referring to this or to this or to this or to this. Any one of these values can be present where each one is variant. It can be system.data.oracle client. This is going to be system.data.odbc or OLEDB. Anything. So we can have any one of these three, whichever. And moreover, this being a string, can it come from a configuration file? And once it comes from the configuration file, this whole line will become dynamic. So yes, we would dynamically decide which factory to be instantiated using provider factories.get factory. And once the factory is manufactured, I mean, once the factory is ready, object is created, here we will have the facility using factory create other objects. Like we have create command, create connection, create data adapter, create parameter. Like this, different methods are there. So I want to create what? Create connection. Now this create connection, as you can see, returns a new instance of the provider class that implements data DB connection. So we have DB connection, which is inherited from IDB connection. And DB connection is implemented by the class which is there in the factory whose name we did not know. But we know that because we have used SQL Server, that will be internally system.data.sqlclient.sqlconnection, because we know already. Otherwise, we don't need to know. So can I say ultimately this line for us is doing this internally because of this factory? Likewise, if this factory object is used, that is Oracle client, internally it will be Oracle connection. Now connection is created. Connection string is set. Through connection we have created command. Through command we have created parameters. Parameters are initialized with their properties. Parameters are added to the command. Parameter values are set. Everything is ready. So will this code execute? Let us confirm it. So I want to now make this class as the startup. So I go to program.cs and change here. Run. Execute. Size property is invalid, size 0. Okay, we have issue here where we have to actually give size, where obviously size has to be in varchar. So how to give size? Parameter dot db type direction get hash code is nullable to string value. Direct value is there. Size doesn't seem to be required. Problem is copy paste here. This I have to change to integer. This is what? Name. This is salary. Salary should be db type dot decimal. Now let's run once again. Click. Insert it and we got the record number 37. Perfectly, it is working. You can even go to SQL Server and verify in the table 37th row is added. With the name E1 and null for binary. Perfectly working. So this is how, with the help of factory, very small piece of code, with the help of the factory, we are able to create a connection object. And through, and mind you, here what we did connection.create command. Instead, if needed, we can write factory.create command. Even this is fine. Factory.create command. All this is fine. And rest all is dynamic data, so absolutely no problem. This is a string. It can be coming from somewhere else. This is a string. It can be coming somewhere else. These are values. Of course, I hard-coded, but they can also be variables. So just to demonstrate on similar lines, let me also execute one more method which will fetch data. There we will see reader how to handle. So this is for select. We want to select. I showed you insert, update, delete will not be different. BTL select. Now for this, we can use a stored procedure which we created earlier, get all employees. though it is taking say 10 seconds of time, that 10 seconds of time we will remove from the stored procedure. Get all employees, modify, let me comment this. So this stored procedure is returning result of complete employee table. Execute, good enough. Now back to studio, we'll copy the code. I wrote that code in this form. This is the code, copy, we'll put it here. So right now this is functional but only for SQL Server. So change it again, IDB connection, and what will you do here? Work with factory. How to get factory? DB provider factory is equal to DB provider factories dot get factory and give your system dot data dot SQL client and factory dot create connection helper dot connection string here command dot create command command dot command text command dot connection and this is IDB command. For data reader, what to do? Does not contain a definition. Command dot should be connection, not factory dot actually. And here what to do? Command dot execute reader return I data reader. So just change SQL data reader to I data reader. And that's it. The code has again become completely provider independent. Run this, click on select, we get the complete data. So like this, it is very much possible to write code which is provider independent, though it could become little longer. So you have to now see, if you are in future ever going to change your database, you might have to do a trade-off with writing little longer code and achieve completely managed provider independent coding. Factory is what which made the whole thing possible. But if you are very sure, generally databases don't change. Once you have decided on one particular database, the lifetime of the project generally don't change. So you have to really work out with the team, with the client on the possibility, and then accordingly write this piece of code. That's all in this video. Thank you.